I'm gonna make this quick this year. I'm raising money for Johns Hopkins Children's Center because they saved my oldest daughter's life twice, and my youngest children were in a NICU in a hospital that's affiliated with Johns Hopkins. So any amount of money that you can help me raise really means so much to me because it really, my daughters would not be here, and my son would not be here without Johns Hopkins Children's Center. So you'll find links below, and thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.
It's time for Eric Checks Out ChromaGun. Hey guys, how's it going? I'm here for another Eric Checks Out, where I play a game for about half an hour, give or take, and see if I ever want to play it again. This time it's ChromaGun. I received a Steam key for ChromaGun in exchange for review, so that's what I'm doing here. And the game's loading up now. Let's see. There we go. Not sure why it's been having some weird issues with the capture, but that's okay. Anyway, so yeah, so I got this for free, but seemed like Portal-ish, so I wanted to check it out. So let's jump right in. Oops, looks like it's shrunken over here as well. No big deal, just fix it right there. All right, let's get into it. It's been a pretty crazy week this week with my mother-in-law gone. Just Danielle and I taking care of the twins. So I gave Danielle a break on feeding Sam tonight, and I decided, what the heck, why not? Might as well play a little game. So I'm at Chromatech. Right mouse button zooms in and out. Ooh, I hear the sound rotating around. I'm not sure if this thing records in stereo, but I definitely hear it going from one side to the other. Okay. Very cool.
Welcome to the Chromatech Test Lab. You're here because you're the best of the best. Not because you were in need of 10 bucks and nobody else signed up. Before we start, we need to test your general mobility. Make your way down the corridor towards the exit door. Note that the exit is the part of the wall that looks different from the other parts of the wall. Also, it says exit.
Okay, so it looks like they're going for a similar sarcastic tone, just like Portal. This woman apparently is not here to talk to me. I do like that there's a B-side over here. That's pretty cool. They definitely got the look of a corporate lobby pretty well. Alright. Huh. Some 10-gallon drums there. Alright. That was a long walk to the exit. Are these meant to be like a padded room? Interesting. Interesting. All right, well, I guess they're gonna teach me this concept.
Sensational.
Now.
Sensational. Please pick up the semi-automatic nano-acrylic projectile firearm right in front of you. This is the ChromaGun, patent pending, that you've heard so much about. Okay, of course you haven't heard about it. We here at ChromaTech know how to keep secrets, and so should you. Now, paint the worker droid to move it out of the way, then exit the room using the room exiting technique you've learned in the previous room.
So far, so good.
paint them and they go to the corner. Aw, nothing for shooting the cameras, huh? That was one of the fun parts of the portal gun. I gotta shoot the walls, I guess. Okay. Now shoot him, then shoot a wall. Okay. Next level. The more vicious a worker droid looks, the more vicious it is. Alright, that's a tautology, and it's also pretty cool. Okay. I tried jumping, and it didn't work. Alright.
Sensational! Please walk towards the exit again. We're confident you've acquired all the necessary skills to complete this simple exercise.
What the? I have unlimited paint. A fire extinguisher. It can be mixed on canvas. I'm not good at that. My wife is really good at that.
Paint the ChromaGun fires is a specially developed blend of partially semi-lethal, dangerously radioactive isotopes, and will paint any surface not designed not to be painted by it. That being said, please do not sniff, touch, or especially lick the paint.
What am I supposed to do in here? Paint the whole room? Ah. Whoa. Okay. So far, so good. Huh. Interesting. What in the heck? Whoa. That's a lot of worker droid things. Alright. Interesting. Did it attract any of the other ones? No, it did not. That's okay. Alright. I think that's enough tutorial. I think we should go on to the next thing. Okay.
Please find. Subsequently, step into the trigger. Sensational! Please do not leave the trigger to ensure the continued opening of the exit door.
Right, pretty clearly I'm supposed to make him go over there.
Sensational! You have successfully understood the correlation between triggers and worker droids. That makes you more intelligent. Then 39% of test subjects and 97% of test monkeys.
That's kind of scary. Okay. Let's bring one of those in here. Let's see. All right. And then I want him to go where? Here, maybe? There? Okay. Oh. It's not as complicated as I thought it would be. Unless there's a secret room I didn't end up going to. kind of disappointed.
The attraction the ChromaGun's paint generates is based on a very complex set of mathematical vector operations. So instead of not understanding me explaining it to you, try it out now.
So basically he's saying it could go in the middle, which I had noticed before. It's kind of a bummer that some of these tips don't appear right before they're needed. Alright, so I'm guessing this is going to have to be like all four corners. Okay. Looks like these are very quickly getting quite complex.
It is worth noting that unlike the ones you've encountered in the previous rooms, the worker droids in this next room are not deactivated, but hibernating. Much like you and me, they do not take kindly to being shot at with paint pellets. Please do not disturb them, because even though they're not designed to kill you upon contact, due to miscommunication in engineering, they will.
Very Cave Johnson-like. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Okay, so it'll go towards me unless there's a wall for it to go towards. Interesting.
The ChromaGun's paint can be mixed on canvas. If you remember your time in kindergarten, that part should be easy. If you don't remember or you never actually went to kindergarten, you may attend the Chromatech seminar on subtractive color mixing for preschoolers at the end of the test.
What the bloody hell? I don't know if I'm actually supposed to be able to shoot into the other room, or if that's just supposed to show that things are a little wonky here. Alright, that one's green now. That one's orange now. That does nothing. Ah, okay. Interesting. I've broken one on the floor. Okay, I've achieved 100 shots. Good for me. Alright, so how do I not kill myself? Nope, do that. Okay. That part's kind of not intuitive. I guess it's because that one has the honeycomb pattern on it. What are these broken brown ones doing here? Oh well. So I've got a 1, 2, 3 in the corner now.
To continue the test, please acquire the upgraded tri-colored ChromaGun. As without it, you would not be able to solve the subsequent rooms and eventually succumb to hunger.
Alrighty, good for them. Alright, let's see here. So this one needs to be painted blue. This one needs red. This one needs yellow. Okay. I think we're gonna start getting more complicated now. Let's see. So I need orange. Just let's say yellow and red. Let's see. Okay. This is purple. That won't change. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Oh no, it's following me. Hide, hide. Hello. Ha, you can't come out here, can you? I guess I need to let it kill me. No hugging.
Remember, if you want helpful worker droids to aid you with the completion of this chamber, these are not the worker droids you're looking for.
Hilarious. Alright, so this dude is purple. Oh, I need to make the wall purple. The wall is letting me know that it's red and blue. Got it. Preschooler. Alright. So I can color the droid, and I can color the walls. There we go. Right, this is the most complicated one we've done so far. Let's see. So, yellow and blue here. Blue and red. Okay. Add some yellow. Alrighty. Now we have these non-scary droids over here. A blue droid. And the next chamber. Okay. The name Deadly Electrified Maintenance Tile does not contain the word deadly by accident. Okay. So now we're starting to add some hazards. So we need red over here. There we go. Had to kind of get it going before we go over there. Whoa. What the bloody heck? Why is everyone trying to attack me? At least they can't come through here. Alright, so I need one blue. I need a green. Okay. I need a purple. I need an orange. There we go. It's kind of scary. There's a bunch just floating around in there. Alright, where the heck am I supposed to go? Okay, so somebody has to be turned on. Make a brown, I guess. Is it a brown I want to make? Or orange? Let's see. Wake up. Oh, shoot. Oh, my God. What did I do wrong? Oh, shit. Why? Oh, my God. Oh, no. Is there a pause button? There we go. It wasn't brown enough. Right? No? What the F? Wake up. Oh, there's two guys coming after me. What the bloody hell?
In light of your recent blunders, and they are many, we feel we are obliged to inform you that Kung Fu has been proven to be futile against worker droids.
Okay, let's try this again over here. Let's see. Okay, and just regular blue. Okay. I guess that's one potential one. Let's see. Is it brown? Oh no, why?
Remember, if you want helpful worker droids to aid you with the completion of this chamber, these are not the worker droids you're looking for.
Not sure what I'm doing wrong. I feel like, am I just being colorblind or something? How do I reset one? Is there a way to reset it? Maybe not. Maybe brown is always brown. That's kind of a bummer. Oh shit. Scary. That literally made me jump in my seat. That's crazy. Alright. Can I finally figure this out? Let's see. This looks brown to me. Is it not brown? is that not the right color? Somebody be attracted to this color. Nobody? Anybody? Okay, too. Oh my god. I don't know, man. Maybe I need to turn on colorblind mode.
If you want helpful worker droids to aid you with the completion of this chamber, these aren't the worker droids you are looking for.
All right, let's see if I can do this with colorblind mode on. Almost feels kind of like cheating with the symbols, but right, so these are everything, right? So it says they're brown, right? So if I do this, all right, that matches that. So why is it not sticking? Do I need to do it to like every freaking wall? Let me do one over there. One right behind him, right? Okay, so if I wake him up, why is he not attracted to that wall? Is this a bug? I think this is a bug. That symbol looks like that freaking symbol, does it not? Why is it not attracted? Alright, what am I missing? What clue am I missing? Because this just seems really dumb. Like a glaring error.
Remember, if you want helpful worker droids to aid you with the completion of this chamber, these aren't the worker droids you are looking for.
Okay, I have an idea. Final idea. And then I'm done with this level because it's almost been half an hour. So when I look at the when I look at that symbol, when it's rebooting, it shows the middle as being danger, right? Like, these will never help you, right? We can't paint them. But looks like maybe we can pull this guy over. Yo, numbnuts, come here. Oh, shit. There we go. Ah, finally got it. That's what the problem was. That was the whole droid you're looking for thing. It looked like they were just being cheeky, but really that's not it. Shh. Crap. Hopefully that's good enough. This game is not very forgiving if you accidentally repaint something. Oops. Okay, so now it's purple. Okay. Almost done. Do I have to drag him over here? I have to drag someone over here. This is where I done messed up. Doing it wrong. There you go. I broke the mother effer. And now there's no repainting. Alright, shall I redo this one more time? See if I can get it this time. Change that wall to a different color. What's up, homie? Come chase me. Yikes. Alright. You need to be made green. You need to be made purple. To be made yellow. You need to be made orange. Okay, so here I want. Oops, darn it. Okay. This game is not forgiving of mistakes at all. What level am I in? Floor 4. Alright, I'll do one more try. Gosh darn it. Portals are so much easier. Just two buttons. There's three different things. Plus combinations that you can't erase. I need some kind of eraser gun. Okay. 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 So I could make. So this is red already. And that one's red. So I guess I could change the back over there. But he's stuck in there, huh? Okay, so he's stuck in there. Can I pull someone from here? I think this is going to put him in the exact middle of the room. So now I need to make this a different color. Now I can exit. Oh boy, look at that. I did it. Woohoo! Alright, I think I'm going to just leave it at this for today. So, yeah, that's ChromaGun. If you like Portal or those type of games where you're kind of moving things around to open doors, looks like a great game to check out. At least the devs are smart enough to realize that if you are colorblind, you might not understand. I mean, you might not be able to play the game because you might not be able to see what the colors are. So they have these little icons that help. The icons also help if you happen to be very bad with remembering the way that colors mix, which is really good. Overall, it looks pretty good. Would I play it again? Perhaps. The story is not as immediately compelling as I remember Portal being, and I enjoy the physics puzzles more than I enjoy these color puzzles. I would say that I would put this on my list of games that I would like to get to.
The exit is but the big door, and it says exit in big letters.
But I might not get to it, anytime soon. So anyway, this has been Eric Checks Out. I'm Eric, and I was playing ChromaGun. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later. Bye.